Yani bante kusalani silani kimani sansati. Good morning, venerable sirs, friends in the Dhamma. Today also I am very glad to be here and share something from the Buddha's teaching. As most venerable mentioned, today I would like to discuss relevant with Sila. Sila means the morality. If you can remember, last time I already discussed about Dana, that is the first perfection, intent perfection in Theravada tradition, and sixth perfection in Mahayana tradition. Dana, charity, as well as morality, also very important in our spiritual journey. Sometime you have heard the Pali word as well as Sanskrit word Sila. In Sanskrit we call it Sila. What is the meaning of Sila? The discipline of physical, mental and verbal. That is the basic meaning of morality or sila. Is it clear? Sila, sometime the Buddha compared to the ground or to the earth. When we want to build a very huge or very tallest building, we should have the good foundation. Without good foundation, we cannot build properly a good building. In order to have a good foundation, we should have very solid, very robust, very strong earth. The sila of morality, in this case, similar to earth, similar to the ground. Another example, in order to grow some kind of plant, flower, vegetable or something, we should have a good plot of land. Without a good plot of land, we cannot grow something very nicely, very properly. Therefore, according to Buddha's teaching, sila or the morality is very important. Actually, this is a very huge subject. This is a very huge area, even though I would like to discuss something very briefly. Once the Buddha was living in Jetavana monastery, Venerable Ananda, he visited the Buddha and asked that question in Pali, what I uttered earlier. Kimatyani bante kusalani silani kimani sansati. Venerable sir, what is the meaning of kusalani silani? Venerable kusala here, what is the meaning of kusala? What is the meaning of kusala? Kusala means?
Skillful.
Kusala means skillful. Venerable Ananda asks, what is the meaning of skillful morality? In order to be virtuous people, in order to be moral people, basically Buddhist followers observe. They preserve mostly five precepts. Some people 8 precepts or 10 precepts. Some people have enough knowledge what they are observing, what they are protecting, what they are preserving. Actually, if we ask what is the meaning of five precepts, unfortunately, some Buddhist followers, they really don't know the meaning of five precepts. Anyway, even without proper knowledge, protecting any kind of precept is very important according to Buddha's teaching. Here, the question that raised by Venerable Ananda, what is the meaning of skillful morality? Skillful virtue. Because of by observing any kind of precept, we develop, we cultivate our mouth, our physical body, and our mind. That is the only thing we do by practicing any kind of discipline role. Maybe 5 precept, 8 precept, or 10 precept. There is a big difference. Kusala, and sometimes we Buddhist people ask, they have misconception about merit and kusala. By doing maybe charity or any kind of good deeds, we can do merit, we can collect merit. At the same time, we are training our mind as physical body. That is the kusala. Suppose we practice not to kill, not to steal, not to have mixed sexual, and not to lie, not to any kind of intoxicant. Because of something, some people addicted really to harm other people, to harm any kind of sentient being, to steal, mixed sexual, adultery, and to lie, and some kind of drugs. If we can stay from them, that is our skills. Otherwise, we don't have any skills. We don't practice, we don't train our mind as well as physical body. Immediately, we cannot achieve final liberation, according to Buddha's teaching. Some people can do it, but some people not able to do it. Even the Buddha, suppose his career, he practiced his mind bit by bit. It has taken a very long time, number of eons. Even at his last time, he practiced 6 years, especially meditation. His mind concerned with really meditation and then achieve the liberation. That is the final goal of all Buddhist people. Then, Venerable asks, what is the meaning and what is the result of skillful morality? Then the Buddha mentioned Pamojjhattam. Sometimes you don't know the meaning of Pamojjha. Pamojjha means not to distract. If any person commit any kind of wrong action, definitely those people have to regret because of their mind, not happiness, not happy. In their mind, no peace, no calmness. If any person practice at least 5 precept, 10 precept, 8 precept, their mind very peaceful. That is the Pamojjha. In Buddha's time, sometime you have heard, there was a king, Ajatasattu. Have you heard? Ajatasattu. He is sponsor for the first council, Buddhist council. But he killed his father. That is the most dangerous, most powerful, unwholesome action in Buddhism. If anybody kills mother or father, or hurt the physical body of Buddha, and kill the liberated one, they cannot repay that unwholesome action. Extremely difficult to overcome from that unwholesome action. For example, if anybody commit some kind of wrong action, their mind are not in peace. They have to regret. If any person doesn't commit any kind of wrong action, his mind, her mind is peaceful. That is the first step. Pamojjhattam, that means very peaceful. And then the third, then Venerable Ananda asked, what happened after that? Then the Buddha mentioned that person become to sukha. Sukha means the happiness. Actually, they are very subtle differences of our mind. Sometimes we cannot give the proper English word, proper English term to those Pali terms. Sukha means that person physically as well as mentally become to happiness in the third level. And fourth, Passaddhi. Passaddhi means more subtle level in our mind and in our physical bodies. If anybody doesn't do any kind of wrong action, then he is not distracted person. And peace in the mind, then the mind as well as physical body become to happiness. And then the next level, Samadhi. I think you know the meaning of Samadhi. What is the meaning of Samadhi? Yeah, the last level of Noble Eightfold Path, Samma Samadhi. Samma Samadhi means the right concentration. Right concentration. If anybody commit any kind of wrong act, his mind doesn't become to concentration. He is always regretting. He is always rethinking what I have done, like that. Is it clear? And the next level, Yathabhuta Jnana Dassana. Yathabhuta Jnana Dassana means that person is able to see the things as they are. Did you get the idea? We have to see the things as they are. What is the meaning of that? Do you have any idea? We have to think this, we have to see the things as they are. It is very important in Buddha's teaching. Do you have any idea?
Huh? We don't project ourselves onto things.
Yeah, we have to project.
Insight.
Huh?
To have the insight.
Yeah, we have to insight. What is the meaning of insight? Insight means we should see the Four Noble Truths. That is the Yathabhuta Jnana Dasana, or the seeing the things as they are according to Buddha's teaching. We have to understand the Four Noble Truths. What is the Four Noble Truths?
There is suffering.
Suffering.
There is a cause for the suffering.
Cause of suffering. Cessation and the way to, yeah, that is the Noble Eightfold Path. Yathabhuta Jnana Dasana means when that person develops his skill step by step, then he is able to see the things as they are. Just the Four Noble Truth. The last link of course, Noble Eightfold Path is right concentration. Samahito bhikkave yathabhutan dasati. The Buddha mentioned when a mind of a person become to concentration, he is able to see the things as they are. Without good concentration, without right concentration, we cannot see the things as they are. Is it clear? We have to understand, we have to see, we have to examine the things as they are. For example, when the Buddha visited to a certain city we call the Rajagaha, the most senior disciple of the Buddha, who are the most senior, the two chief disciples of the Buddha, Venerable Sariputta and Venerable Moggallana. Then Venerable Sariputta met the Buddha's disciple, Assaji. Then he asked, who are you? Then he explained, I am a disciple of the Buddha. What kind of teaching he is practicing? I am not a very expert person in Buddha's teaching, but I know a very few teaching of Buddha. Then he explained, Ye dhamma hetu pabhava, tesang hetu tathagato aha. The cause and effect. cause and effect very briefly. Immediately, Venerable Sariputta understood and he became the first level of liberation. We call the Sotapanna, the extreme entry. Some people very quickly understand the things as they are. But for some people, have to practice repeatedly. Anyway, without right concentration, we are not able to achieve liberation. We are not able to achieve the highest level of our minds. That is the skill, step by step. And then, Venerable Ananda asks, then what is the result? What are the skill of right concentration? Then again, the Buddha mentioned, Nibbida Nirodha means that concentration also not enough to achieve liberation. Again, we have to skill, we have to practice, we have to train our mind. Nibbida Virodha means further we understand the real nature of everything. And then the last link, what is the, Venerable Ananda asks, then what is the result of seeing the things as they are? What is the meaning of seeing the reality of thing? Then the Buddha mentioned vimutti jnana dasana. Sometimes you are very familiar with this word vimutti. Vimutti means the liberation. Vimutti jnana dasana. The knowledge, jnana means the knowledge of vimutti means liberation. And dasana means we have to see. We have to understand the knowledge of liberation. In other words, there is a very special knowledge in practicing the spirituality we call the asavakya jnana. In Sanskrit language, we call the asravakshaya, eradication of all defilement. Is it clear? Eradication of all defilement is the final goal or the final knowledge of a practitioner. Even the Buddha, he became to asavakshaya jnana. Even other liberated one became to that level, eradication of all defilement. We also train our mind to that level. Therefore, in order to understand, in order to see the nature of liberation, the knowledge of liberation, we have to observe, we have to practice sila, we have to practice morality. Without morality, we cannot achieve the liberation. Without morality, no correct wisdom. Without correct wisdom, on the other hand, no morality. For example, in Buddha's time, very educated, very rich Brahmin, his name was Sonadanda, he visited the Buddha. And he asked some kind of question. And Buddha also asked him encounter question. And while they were discussing, when Buddha asked, what is the connection between morality and wisdom? And Buddha asks, can you separate those two things? And can you eliminate one of them? Then he said, no. Because of morality clings the wisdom. Wisdom clings the morality. Without morality, no correct knowledge. Without correct knowledge, no morality. Therefore, morality and wisdom always connected. That is the importance of practicing morality. Without morality, nobody can achieve liberation. The liberation is, in this case, the wisdom, the right wisdom. That is the importance of practicing morality. Morality is very important in Buddha's teaching. Okay? That is the, my very short Dhamma talk today.
Sadhu, sadhu.